But the first one is a pellet feeder. It's a fantastic way of catching fish. It's in line, so it's free running.
Can you buy the same feeder with an elasticated version?
Yeah, you can get the same one, but a lot of fisheries ban it and they only allow them in line, so you've got to check when you go on your fishery which you're allowed to use. And the only time personally that I use the elasticated feeder is for distance. When I'm fishing a right long way out, I find it better with elastic. I don't know why, it just works better than it does with in line. Maybe it's something to do with that bouncing free up and down, I don't know, but distance, it makes a difference. But the method feeder, all it does, it's in line, it runs free, and it runs onto a coral quick change bead. One of the finest little inventions ever. It acts as a bead, so it acts as a cushion as the feeder comes down. It also comes apart so you can put your hook lengths on, and if you want to change the bait, you can easily change your hook length and your bait. When you're fishing with the pellet feeder though, usually the hook bait is a pellet. I usually band on a PR36 with a little band on, I usually band a pellet. It's quite interesting, Clint, that when you fish with pellets in the feeder, you have to have a pellet on the hook. But when you're fishing with ground bait, you can get away with other baits sometimes, like corn or meat or a pellet or maggots. But when you've got pellets around the feeder or in the feeder, then you're always better with a pellet on the hook. And all you do is get your little stretcher band over the middle of the pellet, and it's like that. It's also important just to have a little gap between the hook and the pellet as well. A lot of people have it too long away and finish up bumping fish around the mouth. That's quite important. To fill the feeder, it's quite easy. All I do, I hold it in my right hand, like so.
Sharp?
Yeah, they are sharp, aren't they? Yeah. Like that. Just get a few pellets in one and just tip them in, just fill it up, and then just squash them in. Now, it's important you don't press them really in because they've got to come out. And if you press them too in, they won't come out. So just press them in gently, get your hook bait, put that in the middle, get some more pellets, just put it on top, and a little squeeze, then tip them off and it's all ready for casting in. What happens is that hits the water, it's the bottom, you want it to hit the bottom intact and the pellets will come out with your hook bait, the fish come in, too late, got you.
It looks actually like it's forced in, but I take it the pressure of the water will pop that bait straight out.
That's exactly what happens, yeah. It comes out and it all lays just there. The fish can only get in one way, unlike a method feeder where they can get it at different ways. They're fighting to get into that one spot. This particular way of fishing is awesome. I think I use it a lot when it's deeper water, because on the method sometimes with pellets it's sometimes will come off quite easy or easier, with this they're always going to be in.
And that way you avoid fish coming up in
absolutely
water and line bites.
Yes, it's so important that lands on the bottom in one piece. You don't want it coming out, the hook bait coming out while it's going through the water. It's a lot easier with a pellet feed than it is with the method.
I think that one's on, mate.
Yeah, that's on, pal.
Oh.
All you've got to do is make sure you pick up when there's a fish on. A lot of people strike at line bites. Then when you get a fish, just keep the rod low and just wind it nice and steady, not too fast, and the fish will swim towards you. And then when you get it quite close, under the rod tip, just hold it, lift it up.
And bash me round the head with it.
Yeah, and get your round head. There you go. Simple as that. As long as I've had to wait all day, though.
Take your word for that, I think.